DuPage, Kane, and Kendall County 4-H has a multi-part bridge building challenge for you, which is inspired by our Bridge Bust event. In this part of the challenge, we want you to build a popsicle stick bridge and see how much weight it can hold. You can find complete challenge specifications in the challenge details document on our website at go.illinois.edu/stem4hdkk. For the construction portion of this challenge, you'll need the following supplies: popsicle or craft sticks, along with wood or school glue. We also recommend you have a ruler or tape measure and something to use as clamps, such as binder clips. If you decide to try to build a suspension bridge, you may also use string or fishing line. You'll also need two elevated surfaces that are the same height for your bridge to span. You'll be using these materials to build a bridge that can span an opening of at least 10 inches between two elevated surfaces. Your bridge also may not have any piers in between your elevated surfaces and should only overlap onto the surfaces by 2 inches on each side. The bridge should include a bridge deck and design that allows you to load weight onto it safely. We recommend working with your parents or guardians to help figure out what objects you may be able to use as weights. With these specifications in mind, you're ready to design your bridge. When designing, watch our bridge overview video and take a look at pictures of real-life bridges to get inspiration. We recommend sketching or prototyping your design before you start construction. You can even do a drawing at actual size. Once you have a plan for your bridge in mind, start gluing your craft sticks together. Use wood glue for this if you have it, but otherwise school glue will work. In order to ensure a strong bond between the pieces, we recommend using something like binder clips to apply pressure to the sticks as they dry. Once your bridge is built, allow the glue to dry for the amount of time specified on the glue bottle. Once glue is dry, test your bridge with parental supervision using heavy objects in your home, like cans and books. We recommend keeping your bridge close to the ground when testing to help minimize risk when the bridge eventually breaks. Also consider completing testing somewhere where you won't do damage to the floor if a break occurs. Be sure to stay as far back as possible when placing loads and ensure no body parts or pets are close to the bridge or under the bridge deck. Load the bridge with weight slowly so that you can easily identify the objects it was able to hold before it broke. Record the maximum bridge load by placing the objects it was able to hold on your home scale. If you had fun, challenge yourself to use your observations from your first bridge to make improvements and build a second bridge. In the challenge document on our website, go.illinois.edu/stem4hdkk, you'll find directions on how you can share your creations with us via email or on social media. We're excited to see your bridge designs. If you had fun with this challenge, consider participating in our yearly Bridge Bust activity, which we host every winter. In this challenge, youth or family teams build bridges using a supplied kit that includes balsa wood and wood glue. We then test the bridges by adding weight until they bust. It's a really fun event, and we've had bridges hold over 70 pounds. Learn more on our website.